and explain why we're still celebrating, even after all these years.
Oh, please, dear. I want to hear all about it.
Okay, to start, we have to go to before the first Christmas and visit a little place called Nazareth.
Ooh, who's that?
That's Mary. She is going to marry a man named Joseph. And that's Joseph. He is a carpenter.
What's he doing?
Building something. Carpenters are always building something.
I wonder if it's a cradle.
I think you're getting a little ahead of our story.
Who's that other guy? He's all shiny like us.
That's Gabriel. He's an angel. He has come to talk to Mary. Why don't we listen?
Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. How will this be? The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of the God.
The angel told Mary that she is going to have a baby, will be the Son of God.
Then what?
God sent an angel to speak to Joseph in a dream.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save people from their sins.
All of this was done in fulfillment of an ancient prophecy. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him Immanuel. Oh, and the name Immanuel means God with us.
Wow, that's a great name. What did Joseph do when he woke up?
He did just what the angel told him to do.
Okay, so what happened next?
Caesar, the Roman ruler, ordered that everyone had to be counted.
Why would he do that?
Something about taxes, whatever those are. But in order to be counted, everyone had to go back to their family's hometown. It was a pretty long and difficult trip for Mary and Joseph, especially since Mary was expecting a baby.
Where did they have to go?
They went to a little town called Bethlehem.
Bethlehem? Isn't that the one they sing about? The one they call the little town of Bethlehem?
Yep.
I really like that song. They even sing about how the Simon stars go by.
I think they're gonna sing it now.
Star.
There was no tree on the first Christmas, but there was a star.
Where?
We're getting there. First, you have to hear more about Mary and Joseph.
Okay.
So Joseph went to Bethlehem to be counted, and Mary went along with him.
Look, Mary and Joseph have arrived in Bethlehem. I hope they have somewhere nice to stay. Mary looks very tired.
You're right, but there was no room for them in the inn, so Mary and Joseph stayed in a stable.
A stable? Do You mean like for cows and horses and goats and sheep?
Yes. Mary and Joseph stayed in a humble stable. There, Mary had her baby, and she wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger.
Why did they put the baby in a manger?
It was probably the safest and best place they had for him. I'm sure that Joseph lined it with fresh new hay and stood watch over Mary and the baby during the night. Jesus, which means the Lord saves. And now, for the first time up in the sky, there was a new star announcing the birth of the Messiah.
Hey, look, I think they're going to sing again.
They do that a lot at Christmas time. You get used to it.
child's a really great son. Just think, a new star in the sky? How wonderful, how glorious. No one on earth could have missed that.
It's amazing that not only did people miss the Messiah then, but they still miss him today. Maybe it's because they aren't really looking for him. But God didn't rely on a new star to announce the birth of his son. He also sent an angel to tell a group of shepherds about it. Of course, it surely frightened the shepherds to suddenly see an angel.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all people.
When the angels had left them and gone to heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph, as well as the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Themselves.
We are three kings of Orient.
Aaron gives me traverse afar.
Field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star.
Wait a minute, what are they saying?
It's from an old song about three wise men. They're saying that there are three kings from the east and that they traveled a long way to get here.
Oh, I get it. And they saw the new star and they followed it because they were wise enough know that it meant the Savior had been born.
That's right. Listen, I think they're gonna sing about it.
Presents.
Who are they for?
Gifts are for baby Jesus. They are gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Gold, because he is the king. Frankincense, because he is the high priest. And myrrh, because of his sacrifice.
Hey, where are they going? Bethlehem's over there. Hey, fellas, you're going the wrong way. Baby's over there.
They're going to Jerusalem, to the palace, to look for the King of Jews.
But why? The baby's in Bethlehem. Over there, he's born in the stable.
They went looking for the baby king in a palace, but they didn't find him there.
Who did they find?
Unfortunately, they met an evil man named Herod, who was the local ruler.
We saw his star in the east, and we have come to worship him.
When Herod heard all this, he was greatly distressed, and all of Jerusalem along with him. He called in the Jewish chief of priests and teachers of the law and asked them where the Messiah was to be born.
In Bethlehem, in Judea, for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel.
Go to Bethlehem. Carefully search for the child. As soon as you find him, come and tell me so that I may worship him too.
So the wise men went along their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down to him and worshipped him. Then they gave their gifts and went back to their own countries. And they were warned in a dream to not go back to Herod.
Why didn't they go back to see Herod?
Because Herod didn't really want to worship Jesus. He wanted to destroy him.
That's horrible.
Yes. Yes, it was.
What happened to baby Jesus?
An angel was sent to warn Joseph in a dream to take his family away to Egypt, where they could be safe. They escaped into the night before Herod had found them.
That's wonderful. Is that the whole story?
There's still a little more. When it was safe to return, the child Jesus and his family traveled back to Nazareth, where he was raised. Jesus was the Son of God, and he did all things that were prophesied about him. Lived a perfect life, and died on a cross for all sin, and rose again to live forever. Now he sits at the right hand of God the Father, and one day he will come to judge the world.
That's amazing. And how do you know all of this?
I saw it all from up here in the sky. For you see, new star, I was the new star that appeared that night.
Really? You are the new star? You're so old.
So is the story, new star, over 2,000 years old, but it's still true today as it was on the first Christmas. That's why we still celebrate Christmas today.
That's amazing. Thank you for telling me this story. I think I will shine a little brighter now that I have learned all of this.
Looks like it's time for another song.